Good morning. We're all cooing over her. She's so absolutely gorgeous. But yes, yeah, since 1809, it's just been all boys.
All boys.
You actually warned Hannah of this when you both got together, isn't that right?
That's correct, yeah.
Yes.
What did you say?
Well, when we got together, I've got two children from a previous relationship, and Hannah obviously wants kids, and she said to me, or I said, well, there's a good chance we're going to have boys. And
did it bother you?
Well, I've always wanted, since I was younger, obviously, like, it would be lovely to have the best of both worlds, one boy and one girl. That's always what I've loved to have. And so I said to Mark, oh, it would be nice to have two children. And Mark was just like, to be honest with you, you're probably going to have two boys, the likelihood. And I was like, well, that's fine. Like, just accepted it. But obviously, deep inside, I was like, oh, it would be nice to have a little girl.
Well, in 2012,
yeah.
You had your little boy.
Yeah.
Right. When you were pregnant, you discovered it was a boy. It was absolutely no surprise. So little Mason's now three.
Yeah. Yeah.
So you did, and your midwife,
yes.
Hannah. So you're surrounded by babies, having delivered over 200, I think.
Yeah, something like that. Yeah.
So you did have those little pangs of not quite envy or jealousy. That sounds quite strong. But you desperately wanted that little girl. And you actually thought it might have been some sort of a genetic condition at that stage,
yeah, absolutely.
Didn't you?
I took it upon myself to ask a few of the consultants and the doctors at hospital, just out of interest, do you know whether it is possible for a male to have only male sperm or only female sperm? And he was just like, well, most of the doctors all just said no, to be honest. It's a 50-50 chance all the time. Like, there's no science to say that a male can only have male sperm. So there's a little bit of hope, maybe, there could be a chance.
Well, how did you hear about Landrum B. Shettles? Because I'd never heard of this man before.
Neither have I.
No?
Never.
Landrum B. Shettles is an American doctor, was an American doctor, in the 1960s, and he developed the Shettles method.
Yeah.
So what is that?
So basically, I heard from a colleague at work, basically she had tried it, when I was saying that I wanted to get a sibling for Mason, and she was like, and I said, oh, we'll definitely be a boy though, which is lovely, but, and we're just saying in passing comment, and she just said, oh, you should try what I tried, and I was like, oh, what's that? And she said, basically the timing of when you have sex, and you basically watch your ovulation cycle, and you can try and time it, because she had three boys, and then she went on to have a girl using this method, and I thought, oh, I'm going to go and read up about this in my textbooks. So I got all my midwifery textbooks out, and there was his research and theory in these textbooks, so I had a good old read, and basically I said to Mark, look, if we're going to try for another one, which we'd agreed that we were going to, why not? Obviously, we're probably going to end up with a boy, which is lovely, and that would have been, obviously, as long as they're healthy, that's 100% all that matters.
And the reason I believed it, I've got two friends who tried that method as well, and ironically, they got the girl.
So what's the timing?
So basically, male sperm supposedly swim quicker, but they die very quickly, and supposedly female sperm swim slower, but they can last for a few days. So the idea is that you have sex before you ovulate, so that there's no egg in the fallopian tubes, and then when the sperm are released, the male sperm will get there first, but they will die pretty much instantly, and the female sperm will wait for your ovary to release an egg and will be the sperm that are waiting for the egg to fertilize. That's the idea anyway. Obviously, there's no evidence to say 100% this is, like, obviously not, but I just said if we're going to try, we might as well give it a go.